Ladies and gentlemen, come gather around, come gather around, come gather around. Today, we got a problem with the angry accent. My accent, not my wife's happy Hyundai, the angry accent. So we're driving down the street, everything's fine and normal, except if you're kind of turning to the right, it goes. And it's not Chewbacca under the hood, there's probably something going on. I think it's a wheel bearing. Let's fix it!
My knees don't like working on the ground, so we're putting this up in the air. And my skin doesn't like this, so we're protecting my skin. Reminds me of my last border crossing. So, air tools are pretty handy. I know a lot of you guys like them electric impacts, and I got a compressor, so I still use air. We are pulling apart the whole front end on this. We are taking off the caliper, gonna hang it by a hook. I think I used one of those elastic strap it down thingies that you have in your car. I don't use them anymore because one time it broke and almost lacerated my neck. Bungee cord. So it's a bungee cord hook hanging the brakes off of the spring. I use my side cutters, which are my favorite tools for removing cotter pins. Honking big impact socket. Well, not an impact socket, just a regular socket. The two bolts on the strut. I had a bit of a problem getting the tie rod end off. This one uses an eye-lock nut on it instead of a cotter pin, and it just didn't like coming off, so I got a bit aggressive. This was, had to repair some damage to put it all back together. Did not have to split the ball joint on this, which is nice, however, a little bit annoying. And there's enough play in the two little bolts that you have to do that I do have to get this thing aligned. There's that bearing. We got to press the hub out of it. Now, you can get front-wheel drive wheel bearing puller kits on Amazon and other places, but I have a hydraulic press. And so this is the way I went, finding various sockets or pieces of pipe to press the hub out, and then we use a splitter to get the what's left of the bearing off of there. And then you got this kind of a snap ring in the back that I used a fair bit of heat from a propane torch and some move-it penetrant to try and get this thing out. Probably be smart to goop this in Neverseize before you put it all back together. But this kind of keeps the bearing from coming out the backside. Once that snap ring is out, big honking socket, you can press that bearing right out. Although I may have guessed poorly on the right size of that, but whatever, it came out. Just had to beat that out. Then I got a pick to help clean out that groove so that the snap ring can go back in nice once I have a new bearing to go in there. You can buy hubs already assembled, but I imagine it's not going to be a very good high-quality bearing. Timken is a high-quality bearing. That's your part number for the 06-11 Hyundai Accent. I bought two, just in case. Only doing one. Looks like a 2-inch, 3/4 drive socket. Did a pretty good job of pressing that into place. And there you go. If you like this hydraulic press, set of free plans, link to a set of free plans in the description below. Help yourself. It's arguably cheaper just to buy one. And then these are from KD Tools. I don't remember where I got them or what the part number is. Leave a comment if it intrigues you. Then just snap the snap ring into the groove and then gently press the hub back into the bearing. I like to use a little bit of oil or any kind of lubricant to make it press in nice and neat. And then we stick the guy back on the ball joint bracket with two little bolts. I never seize the snot out of everything because who knows, I might be in here again. I remember doing wheel bearings repeatedly on, golly, first gen Honda Civic that I had. I went through a bunch of those. Either I suck at putting them together or I was buying pretty cheap bearings. But these are Timken, so it should be pretty good. A little awkward getting these bolts in, but they went in. Never seize on everything, because I like that. And I gambled on not having to do an alignment, but there was enough of a change that I'm going to have to. But the only thing that's adjustable is toe, so that's okay. arguing with that tie rod end because it was not a happy camper, that one. Rotor goes back on, couple screws. And I thought I should put some Never Sees on those screws. So I did on the second one, then took out the first one again. Don't have to do these killer tight. Handy tool to get those off is an impact driver. Plus you get to swing a hammer. Always cool. Like the beat it with a hammer impact driver. Brake calipers go back on. And I confess to using the impact and a universal swivel to do quite a bit of this. Like the video's only like 6 or 7 minutes. I think it took me about 3 hours. But I may have stopped a couple times. You know, for a nap, because I'm old. Always use a new cotter pin. And I get outcome with the side cutters, which are perfect for bending it around and cutting it to the right length. Wheel goes back on, wheel nuts, and I cheat. I've got my little torquing bar that torques them to 80 foot-pounds. I just rattle it on home with the impact. It's a torque wrench and an extension. Ha ha. And there we go. Ready to face the day. Whee.
And there you have it, replacing a wheel bearing on a 2010 Hyundai Accent. Wouldn't imagine doing this without a hydraulic press, although I suspect I probably would in my younger days. But on a scale of 1 to 10, the effort of this job is somewhere between no thank you and you'll need to pay me. So it's done. So now it's about as quiet as the engine is, and I can do my daily commute in peace. So I did buy 2 wheel bearings, because if one's on the way out, I imagine the other's not much farther behind. So it's on a shelf. We may do a video on that one, Cax, but so far it's quiet. So there you go. Good luck doing your own. If you would like a free set of plans on building a hydraulic press, there's a link down in the description for a set of plans to build the press that I have, plus a link to get the air over hydraulic bottle jack, which was certainly nicer than just using your hands. So, as always, thanks for watching. Take care. We'll see you again.